welcome back to Take Your Turn. My name is Tin.
And my name is Ricky. And today we are playing Mountain Goats. Mm-hmm. Mountain Goats is a game for 2 to 4 players. Takes about 20 minutes. It's a nice, small, compact game that you can really just take anywhere, take to a friend's house, pick it up. It's not heavy, it's small. Just throw it in your car even if you want to have it available.
Exactly. Take it to the bar.
Yeah.
Yep. Goes easy.
So,
in this game, you are playing as mountain goats climbing to the top of different mountains, and we can explain the setup. So to set up the game, you'll grab the corresponding point tokens. Based on how many players that you have is how many point tokens that you're playing with. So if you're playing with all 4 players, you play with all the point tokens. If you only have 3 players, just remove one of each number from each of the point tokens. If you're only playing with 2, remove 2.
Yep.
And then there is these bigger point values. Those are bonus points for set collections. If you collect one of each of these numbers, you'll get that set bonus point token.
Yeah.
And then, so to set up the board of the game, you'll put the cards in from 5 to 10, and each of the matching numbers are just in the same column. So all the 5s together, 6s, and so on.
Yeah, they actually kind of creates this nice little picturesque picture of like mountains.
Yeah, it's really cute. And then you select whichever mountain goat that you want to play with. There's these little wooden tokens. It's really bright and colorful. They also come in black and gray for the other players. But today we are going to be red and yellow.
So yeah, that's really the setup. You're putting your mountain goats at the bottom of the mountains to start your climb, and you're really playing this like King of the Hill kind of game against each other as mountain goats climbing up the mountain.
Mm-hmm.
So to start your turn, you would roll the dice, and so kind of have the dice set up here to kind of explain a little bit about how that works. So let's say that this was my roll of the 4 dice. What you're going to do is you're going to create combinations of the dice to choose what number mountain you want to go up. And once you reach the top of the mountain, that's when you're going to score your points. So the 5s take longer to go up than the 10s, just because it's easier to make a bunch of 5s than it is to make 10s. So for this roll here, I could combine them in any way. You can use all 4 dice together if they were lower numbers. You can use the dice individually to make numbers. I could use this as a 6, I could use this as a 5. For this, I could also, if I want to get a 10, I could do that, and I could combine these two to get an 8. So my goat would move up the 10, and then my yellow goat here would move up on the 8. I could also do a 7, a 5, and a 6 to get 3 different hills to go up. It's whatever you want to do, and whatever your strategy is to get the point tokens. Whether you're trying to make sets or maybe you're just trying to get a bunch of 10s, because whoever has most points in the game wins.
Right. And to do that, you can also... So the game ends when 3 of the point token piles have been completely depleted.
Yep.
So you could try to rush and end the game quicker because you don't want the other players to get more points.
Yep. Or the game also ends when this pile is out of the set, and that is one of each of the numbers that you have. So when it reaches the top, you take that point value. If you roll that number again, you take another one if you're already at the top.
Mm-hmm.
And you can do this multiple times. Especially, this is really easy to do on the 5s, because it's a very common number to be able to make.
Mm-hmm.
I might get enough to have 3 5s in my dice roll. And if I'm already at the top of the 5, I can take 3 5 tokens.
Mm-hmm.
So it's really an easy way just to get a bunch of points.
Exactly. But then you can be knocked off the top of the mountain by other players. So at the lower level of the mountains, you can have as many mountain goats at that level. So like, let's say if we had other players in here, all 3 of us can be at the 5, but if any of us were to reach a 5, we would knock Ricky down to the bottom, and I would collect that 5, but I might not be able to stay up there that long, because black or gray could easily knock me down again.
Yep. And that's what happens, yeah. When the goat comes up, you're knocked down to the very bottom, and you have to start climbing the mountain all over again. So it's a constant game of getting to the top, trying to stay there to keep collecting the tokens.
Mm-hmm. And then there is a special thing about the dice rolls. So if you roll multiple ones, you would be able to change one of the ones to any number that you would like. So let's say that for whatever reason you roll four ones.
Unlikely.
Right? But if that happens, you just make sure to keep one of the ones, and these three can be whatever number that you want.
Yep. And then this would be actually kind of convenient to get the three ones, because you can really just play as you want. You know, the one is not very helpful when trying to make these bigger numbers. So yeah, now you reach the end of the game, and we'll kind of like say if I was here and 10 was there, we would then tally up our points,
mm-hmm.
and compare points.
Mm-hmm.
If you have a tie, then you're going to look at the top of the mountain to see who has the most number of goats at the top of the mountain. In this case, yellow would have the most at the top, so yellow would win.
Congratulations.
Yeah. However, if there's a tie of the number of goats at the top of the mountain, then the person who has at the highest point value mountain would mm-hmm. win. So red would win.
Correct.
In this case.
And this is only if you tie with the number of point values from the point tokens. The
yep.
the tiebreakers would go into play.
Yeah.
Yeah, and that's the game.
Mountain goats. I think it's a fun game to play.
Yeah, it's so quick and easy, and it's easy enough to play with kids or some people that aren't into board games. Yeah, there's not too much strategy into
yeah.
it. Yeah.
We've also used it as a little bit like a palate cleanser game.
Yes.
Between some bigger games, you have a group that's playing, you have two games going, you're waiting for someone else to finish up.
Yeah.
It's an easy game just to unpack and
dive
set
in.
Up.
Yeah. Yeah.
But that is Mountain Goats. Hopefully you guys enjoy it. Let us know what you guys think of the game.
Mm-hmm.
If you have any other games you want us to check out, and we hope to see you guys back for our next game.
Yeah, definitely. All right, and now it's time for you to take your turn.
See you guys.
Bye.